Yo, everybody, Star here. What is going on? We're going to be taking a look at the Scrambler class from Tribes Ascend and seeing what he is all about. What exactly does he scramble, and why are his eyes so beautiful? The Scrambler is a specialist. He is best used to destroy buildings, mechanical devices, and anything within a base. He gets away with things easily. That is the common theme here. You get away with things easily. I'm destroying this base turret here, and it cannot lock on to me because I'm scrambling it. You can see my ability being used by the fact that I'm glowing all shiny colors. I can still be seen by enemies, but turrets will not lock on to me, and that makes my job incredibly easy. And however, the fact that people can see me, if I go behind a wall, there will be no indicator of where I've gone, which is very, very common in this game. You can see that the people I'm fighting right now have red icons above their head. That will not be showing up for me while I am scrambling. As a primary weapon, you are equipped with the Arcs Blaster, which is very, very powerful in close quarters, small areas, though I'm having a little bit of trouble killing this guy at the moment. It shoots down some sticky grenades, which will stick to anything, stick to players, stick to surfaces, objects, anything you want, and explode after a short duration. It's very good for destroying generators and fighting people in these close quarters. Once you get into the open, it can be a little bit difficult to use this weapon on players. You also have a pistol which is slightly weaker than the variant that the soldier has. It is called the Sparrow, and Sparrow does not sound very deadly. You have got a grenade which is incredibly powerful, one of the best, most versatile grenades in the game that is pretty much a flashbang. Anyone who looks at it, including yourself, will get a white screen, which you will probably see sometime during this video. It really disorients people, combined with the fact that you can scramble your location on radar, allows you to escape very easily. One of your main goals is to destroy generators because you can get down here relatively easily, but once it's destroyed, your job is not over. You want to make sure nobody can come down here and repair it, and get quick kills on those guys. This next clip coming up actually demonstrates quite perfectly how you can appear to be invisible even though you are technically not invisible, and you can use all of your tools to completely disappear. Enemies are chasing me into their base and decide to throw a flashbang at them to mess up their vision and immediately start to take myself off the radar. Walk over here, and you can even see the guy casually stroll past me, trying to chase me down into the generator room. You feel very sneaky playing the Scrambler class, and you need to play it that way. You need to be a little bit patient, wait for your moment. You know, give people the slip. You don't want people onto you, you don't want them to know what you're doing at any given time. This guy is shooting at me because he saw me, but now because I am scrambling, they have lost view of me, so I am technically invisible. People rely very strongly on the red dots that appear above people's heads. The flashbang there also giving me the chance to blow that guy up, drop him into a giant bottomless pit, and I continue my advance right here towards the generator. That is my main goal. I don't truly care that this guy is fighting me. That's not really my business. What I want to do at all times is destroy generators, destroy base turrets, destroy turrets, and I don't know why he jumped into that hole, but I am completely okay with that. Anything sneaky that you want to do is perfect. You really need to get used to the idea that you want to stay in the enemy's base for as long as you possibly can and just drive them insane. When they finally do catch on to you, you throw a flashbang and you try and disappear once again. If anyone actually comes to try and chase you, you are doing your job correctly, and there are a lot of creative ways to kill people without them ever knowing where you were. The real strength of this class is when you work with other people and you have some teamwork going on, because your ability to scramble is not limited just to yourself. It will also apply to anyone who is near you, who is on your team. So you can group up with a couple of other people and sneak into an enemy base completely undetected, regardless of what class they are, and you can completely ignore whatever turrets they have set up as long as you stay within the radius of the Scrambler. If you ever see one on your team, you should work together with them to stay off the radar and surprise attack enemy bases. You can also use this ability to help defend your own base. When somebody comes in and thinks they can get away with capturing the flag because they didn't see anyone near it, they may soon find out that a Scrambler was nearby and he was hiding a couple of teammates who definitely were within their own base. One extra interesting ability about the Scrambler class is that there is another stealth class in this game called the Infiltrator, and ironically enough, this stealth class is a counter to the other one. If the infiltrator comes within your radius when you are using your ability, you will mess up their cloaking field. You scramble everything. Infiltrators will not be able to cloak if they are standing near you, so you are a direct counter to them, and it's another reason why you can also do some base defense with this class. The infiltrator is a little bit stronger than the scrambler is in the stealth department and sneaking around and destroying generators. But the scrambler has a much broader option to what he can do at any given time because he can help defend the base, because his scramble ability isn't limited just to himself, and because it's so easy to use and you can shoot while it's still enabled. You are the absolute perfect counter to when there are way too many technicians throwing up turrets around a base trying to defend it that way, because they will never lock onto you. Every class in the game can unlock two unique perks within their own class tree that everyone can use once they are unlocked. Ironically enough, the ones unlocked within the scrambler tree don't help the scrambler at all. Once you actually get these, they really don't benefit you at all whatsoever. One of them decreases the time that turrets will take to lock onto you, which you already don't really need to worry about that, and the other one decreases the effectiveness of the enemy radar to detecting you, which you don't really need to worry about ever as a scrambler. So you will be unlocking those more so for your other classes because you will truly never benefit from them. In conclusion, the Scrambler class is an all-around stealth-based specialist, which really aims at harassing people and annoying them as much as possible. And remember, to annoy people, you can't sacrifice your own life. You want to stay in their base, remain a constant threat, where you want people to be thinking, I don't know where that guy went, and I don't want him to blow up my stuff. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, rating, subscribe for more, and catch you guys later. Peace out.